Hello, and welcome to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick. I am playing this blind, I've never played it before, and I read all the things. Beginning now. And after this, I'll give some brief information on the game, the release. And then we'll get into it. Yeah, I didn't read this stuff. In the beginning, there was light and there was darkness. Bardas of light and Octum of darkness, they were opposite yet inseparable entities. After a long, never-ending struggle, the earth and spirit god Durga was born. The spirit bestowed life to the earth and eventually created humans. Under the protection of the spirits and light and darkness, mankind prospered. However, humans are young and imperfect beings. Following selfish pursuits, they created chaos on earth and even distorted the order of the gods. The god of light desired stability, and the god of darkness yearned change. The two fought furiously, and Bardas emerged as the victor, sealing Octum away for eternity. However, because of the link between them, the body of Bardas was utterly destroyed when he sealed Octum away. Soon afterwards, Durga and her spirits fell into a deep sleep. Many years pass by. In Elfilden, the land where the gods sleep, a struggle between the Bardas Church and the Octum Apostles threatens to disrupt the lives of everyone. Mankind has not yet learned to stand on its own and is still entangled by the old ties to the gods. This is a tale of gods and man in the world of Gagarv. Okay, so I'm excited to be playing this. I recently finished the Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, which is supposed to be played before this. I'll get into that in a second. And I've also played the Dragon Slayer, The Legend of Heroes, which is the first game released on a TurboGrafx CD. I'm gonna keep pressing this. So I have some stuff written down. This takes place, well, this was the second game released in Japan. The first one was Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, then A Tear of Vermillion, and Song of the Ocean. And, but for some reason, this game was released first in North America. So, it's meant to be played originally as the second game, so that's the order I'm playing it in. This was released in 1996 in Japan, and then finally in 2005, North America, on the PSP, PlayStation Portable. And a few other things. This takes place actually 56 years before Path of the Moonlight Witch, which is a little complicating, I guess, even with the release put in place. And then Song of the Ocean takes place after this game, but still before Path of the Moonlight Witch. And I'm playing this on the PPSSPP emulator. I read all the things as said. I'm playing this blind, which means I've never played it before. I played through the cutscene and looked around. Looked around the starting area. And that's about it. A Tear of Vermillion. What is vermilion? I had to look this up, because I've seen the word before. Vermilion is a red or scarlet pigment created from mercury sulfide. So, what meaning that may have is remained to be seen. So, after this, I'll be playing Song of the Ocean and then finally beginning the Trails in the Sky series, so I'm excited for that. Let's begin. That's a familiar sound. Cathedral, the holy place and home of the Bardas Church. Two innocent children came to this place where oracles undertake intense training. Now, as soon as I get out to a menu, I will stop the scrolling text like this and it'll be faster. Because, I don't know, I find it annoying myself. It is kind of retro, because games like Shining in the Darkness had this text scrolling. Avin and Eimelle. Avin? Avin? Eimelle? I don't know, I'm going to call them Avin and Eimelle. The siblings lost their parents and were orphaned at an early age. They had put their mourning behind them and were living a peaceful life under Supreme Priest Asperius, who had taken them in. It was very much the same. These games are all the same, really, this Gagarv trilogy. As far as gameplay, appearance, and such, there are a few differences, and only one or two characters that show up between releases. Because these lands are all separated by the Gagarv and the Serpent of the World Mountains or something like that. But yeah, there's a few differences in gameplay, not much from what I understand. Emelia's Avin. This way, Avin. Avin says, I'm sorry to keep you waiting. Did Miss Olesia see you? No, I'm okay. Did you bring it, Avin? Yeah, of course. Here, it's milk. Thank you, Avin. Mimi, Eimelle yells. Come out now, it's safe. Drink as much of this as you like. That was a rather pathetic meow. Avin says she is tiny, but she sure drinks a lot. Eimelle says she must be very hungry. I don't think she has eaten anything in days. Avin says, but what should we do now? Can we keep her without being caught by the professors? Avin says, don't worry. Leave it to your brother. I'm good at hiding things from professors. Eimelle says Avin and chuckling. Thank you. I know I'm asking a lot. You almost never ask me anything. So when you do, I must make it happen. Otherwise I'll be scolded by Gawain. Avin, thank you. Avin says we better go back now. The afternoon prayers will begin soon. We have to get back before the professors find out we're missing. I know. Just a little... Can I stay here just a little longer? Well, okay, just a little. Yes, just a little. Avin chuckles, Eimelle giggles. But just then, Avin, Eimelle! Uh-oh, it's Oracle Alessia. Avin says, oh no, Professor Alessia! Eimelle says, Professor, I'm sorry, I just... Alessia says, good, you're here. It must be the blessing from Bardas that you were not in your room. Come with me. Something's going on. Eimelle says, I'm sorry, Professor Alessia. It's my fault. I found the kitten, not my brother. Uh-oh. That kind of music is never a good sign. Paladin says, run! Leave this to us! Oh yeah, that didn't work. Don't think we can leave it to you. Oracle Alessia screams. And now, stay back. An eerie voice says, I found you, daughter of Durga. Alessia says, Lord Bellias! This is a sacred place. I can't let you desecrate the altar with blood and violence. You'll anger Bardas. Ha ha ha, you fool. Where is Bardas? If he's here, call him. It's not in my nature to use violence on women and children. Don't resist. Give up, Durga's daughter. Wait, says Asparius over there on the right. Well, well, Supreme Priest, or shall I call you Senile Old Man? Asparius says, you have fallen to the trap of darkness, haven't you, Bellias? I know you are responsible for the tragedy in Canafia. And I don't have to explain. Daughter of Durga, I won't let you get away this time. So I'm guessing the daughter of Durga is the... what's her name? I forget her name already. The sister. The little one over there. Go, Alessia! Whoa. Doesn't seem very effective. Ha ha ha. What happened to your peace-loving nature? I thought you'd like to talk. Oh, quite a battle here. Asperia says, Seems to be weakening. You'll only get those kids over my dead body. That might just happen. You can defend against that spell. Old age is a cruel thing. I am far better than you now. Asparius says, you used to be an excellent oracle. Why did you surrender to an evil force? Evil? Evil is Bardas, who brings us false peace. True peace will not arrive without absolute power. Octum is the symbol of good. Octum is the truth. I will guide the world in the right direction with the power of Octum. The ends don't seem to justify the means here. Asperia says, you're possessed, Bellias. It's a pity. Uh-oh. He seems dead or unconscious. I laugh at the power of Bardas. Ours is the true force. That hair, though, you know. If Octum is responsible for that, I don't know. I'd go see another barber. Lord Bellias says, go. Occupy the rest of Cathedral. Okay, he beamed up. So long, my teacher. Okay, the kitten's leading the way. Avin says, who are those guys, Professor? I don't have time to explain it to you right now. Come, quick. Eimelle says, that's her name, Professor Asparius is not coming? Don't worry, he'll catch up soon. As naive as ever, Alessia. Asparius is dead. No one can protect you now. Leave these children alone! Bring them to me. That's an order. Whoa, who's this? Well, well, who do we have here? It's the Sage of Power. Ah, the Sage Gawain, who was mentioned. Lord Bellias, I cannot let you do this. Run, Alessia! You sages have nothing to do with the church. Don't meddle in things that do not concern you. Sages are duty-bound to protect the hope of Elfilden. Those kids are part of that hope. I can't let you take them away. Ha ha ha. Very well then. I shall be the judge of your reputation, Sage. How's it gonna kitten leading the way? That's one smart cat. Knows exactly where to go. The paladin says, Oracle Alessia, this way. Get in the cart. Well, I wonder what kind of creature that is. Come, get in. Whoop, 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 whoop. Let's go. Oh, you better hurry up. Meow. Still a sad meow. No, Mimi, Eimelle yells. All right, the cats are running out. Mimi, Mimi. I'll get her, says Avin. Whoops. That cat's nothing but trouble. It was helping us before, leading us to safety. The Oracle yells, Avin! Yells at Avin. Everyone's yelling Avin. Eimelle yells, Avin, brother! The paladin says, Master Gawain! Now that we all know who each other are, Gawain says, Go! Break into two groups! I'll protect Avin. Who's the one group? I guess all them, and then just the two, Gawain and Avin, is the other group? Alright, they're yelling each other's names. This way! Run! No! I have to protect Eimelle myself! Eimelle! An old man's voice says, Avin! Eimelle, just hang on a bit longer. Hey, Avin! I will save you without fail. Avin! Gah! You're awake, Avin. It's such a fine autumn morning, with not a cloud in the sky. It would be a shame to oversleep. Good morning, Lemuras. Were you having a nightmare? Does this guy know about his sister or what? No? All right. Breakfast is ready. Go wash your face. Thank you for breakfast. It was good. I know it's good. I'm pretty confident in my cooking. When I was young, I couldn't decide if I should become a sage or a chef. Really? Just kidding. Don't give me that look. The secret of its taste is the vegetables from Ourt Village. Ourt Village? When you came here 3 days ago, didn't you pass through there with Sir Gawain? Yeah, I remember that small village. I know the Elder of Ourt very well, so they deliver fresh vegetables once a week. So, Avin, I have a favor to ask of you.
A favor?
I have been so busy lately that I haven't sent my regards to the Elder. I'm going to write a letter to him partly to thank him for the vegetables. Can you give it to him for me?
All right, I'll go.
Here, this is the letter. Thank you. Avin was entrusted with the note to Elder.
Okay, I'll get going then.
After you're done with your chores, why don't you hang out there for a while? The people in Ourt are good people.
Okay. So we are level 0. We have 12 hit points and 8 magic points. There is nothing we can equip, but there are our stats. Experience 0. The only item we have is the note to Elder. Letter entrusted by Lemuras the Sage must be delivered to the Elder of Ourt. We cannot read it. That's another familiar sound. No magic! Wah wah. Can't look at the map yet. History. A lot to fill in. Year 924, Avin and Eimelle are orphans. Supreme Priest Asparius takes them in and they start to live in Cathedral. Year 929, Avin is entrusted to Sage Lemuras by Sage Gawain. And I just know from looking at this before that this is full, well, the rest is all question marks. That's what I'm trying to say. We can save, load, and delete. And we can change the message type to fast now. Button config is fine. We get another pet at some point, so that's the circle again. Word balloons on and off. I don't know if they mean the balloons, like you see the smiling face there. Because, I mean, I turned them off and it's still there. I don't know if it means these balloons. After you're done with... Yeah, same thing. Because that shows up the same as it did before, so I'm not sure what the word balloons are. Because it's still showing here. It doesn't say anything new here. Now, there's books, but the books look difficult for Avin. I can't read books, damn you, Avin. Avin has to learn how to read or something. So boring, he says. There's a book titled Easy Recipe for Fresh Vegetables 1. Now, this is the only book we can read, at least, that I've seen so far, and that's sad, because it's going to be the first book. I have a side series, Let's Read the Books of the Gagar Trilogy, so this will be book 23, I think. The previous ones being from Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. We'll read it here, too, why not? 1. Cut a potato into fine strips. 2. Put them into boiling water and take them out quickly. 3. Cool them in cold water and drain well. 4. This dish will taste good with lots of spices. It is a delicious salad that has a different feel of food than radish and others. That's the cat Lemuras is raising. You can't actually talk to it. The treasure box is locked. We need the key. I don't know where we can find that. So there's a bunny in here as well. I don't know if we can choose one of these for our pets. We had a bunny in the last game, so hopefully get something different this time. That's the rabbit Lemuras was raising. I grab the axe. Okay, I don't. So that's the house, and then... we can run up here. Lookout tower. It's fine. So I guess at some point we'll see encroaching forces or something like that. Encroaching or approaching. This dog is very fast. That's the dog Lemuras is raising, so... I prefer to get a dog or even better, a cat. So we'll see. I found out in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch that you have a choice of pets. I didn't know that until afterwards. I would have chosen something other than a rabbit. Oh, look at that. I didn't see this before when I was looking around. There's a straw scarecrow here. What the heck is this? Says Avin. It's a straw scarecrow, Avin. Alright, so that's it, and then... so we're going to the town now. Outside Ourt. Now here we're blind, I have not played this part. I don't imagine there'll be anything to fight us, because we don't have any kind of weapons or anything. Oh, what a foreboding looking tree. Ourt Village, yay! North Lookout Cottage. Oh, to the north is a lookout cottage. That's one thing. Alright, bridge runs across. Hello? Miles' mother says, "Hello, you must be the one who came to stay with Sir Lemuras. Nice to meet you." Miles' father says, "Welcome, what's your name?" Okay, where's Miles? Avin. The mother says, "It's a good, manly name. We have a son named Mile. You two are about the same age." Father says, "By the way, honey, where did Mile go? I haven't seen him since we finished breakfast. I wonder where he went." Father says, "I don't know what to do with him." Mother says, "Avin, please be a friend to our son. There is no one his age in this village. He's always playing alone. Please be nice to him." "You've come again. I will introduce you to our son, Mile." Well, not yet, you won't, because he's not here. The father says, "I wonder where Mile is goofing around at. Avin could be his first friend." Wait, you're saying that to Avin. Oh, we got a well. Ah, provisions. Must be the vegetables they send us, some of them. Alsa says, "Welcome to Ourt Village. You must be Avin. We opened this tool shop only the year before last. We're new, too. We hope we'll be good friends." Elder Rowan's house? It's a big mansion west of this shop. Okay. I guess that's where we want to go. We can't go behind the counter. Toolsman Torino says, "Look who's here. A young customer. How about some colorful marbles? We just got them from the capital." "No, thank you. I don't have any roses to buy one." Oh, right, right. That must be the unit of currency here. I saw R and P. I was wondering if P stands for peers, like in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. Probably not. "Okay, then. I'll give you one for free. Take any color you like." Avin says, "My favorite color. The color of Eimelle's hair." "You've chosen the crimson-colored one." "Is her hair red?" I didn't notice. Okay, so that's keeping up with the vermilion theme. "Here you go. Please cherish it." Red marbles was obtained. Thanks. "I take great pride in what we have in stock. We also deal with some weapons." I guess you're too young for that, huh? I hope not. I want weapons. Red marbles. Marbles given by a toolsman in Ourt. Has a beautiful, clear red color. And makes a rude sound. Ah! That must be the guy we're looking for. Elder Rowan? Alright. Let me look around a bit more before we talk to him. Because sometimes things change after you talk to the people with the exclamation marks. Fam says, "Hey, you must be Avin. I heard about you from Elder Rowan. You live in a lookout cottage, right? There's nothing special in Ourt Village, but we grow delicious vegetables. Potatoes, carrots, cabbages, and tomatoes. Look forward to our delivery." Okay. There's Elder Rowan. Anyone else to talk to? West is the capital, Filden. Avin says, "Let's just do what we're asked to do." Yeah, no roaming yet. Just want to see if he's saying a second thing. Alright, so we talked to all these people, and there's nowhere else to go, so we'll talk to... what's his name? But there's someone wandering around out here. Let's talk to her first. Yuzu says, You must be the boy who's staying with Sir Lemuras. I'm Yuzu. What's your name? He doesn't answer her. Hey, cheer up. If you don't, how about this? Yuzu tickled Avon's side. Hey, stop it. What are you doing? Haha, have you cheered up now? And what's your name? Avin. Avin, nice name. My grandpa is inside the house. Come back when you're done with your chores. I will play with you. That sounds suggestive. Okay, let's go talk to him. Greetings! I come from a land far away. Huh? Are you by any chance the boy who's staying with Sir Lemuras? What was the name? Avin, right? Yeah. I came here to deliver a letter. Avin handed him the note to Elder. Thank you. Elder opened the letter from Lemuras. I see. Well then. Wait a minute, the Elder says. So you're a cathedral beyond the ocean before you came to Sir Lemuras. Was she like listening in over there? That's right. I've heard about what happened there. I'm sorry about what you had to go through at such a young age. I hope you'll enjoy. Oh, Mile, I'm glad you came. Oh, I thought that was the girl from up there. Come over here. Maybe not. Avin says, who is he? His name is Mile. He's a very intelligent boy. There were no other small children in this village. He must be shy. Oh, okay. I almost forgot. I'm going to write back to the sage, so can you bring the letter back to him? No problem. Please wait for a while. I'll write the letter right away. Please wait till I finish writing a reply. Go look around the village if you like. Hi. There's Mile. Ah, well. He runs off again. Where'd he go this time? Oops. He went over here. Your name is Avin, right? Yeah. My dad told me that you were staying with Grandpa Lemuras. All right. My wish came true. He's singing, I guess? Wait, says Avin. Weird. Where'd he go this time? Hey. What do you want to play, says Mile. What do you mean by play? I just came to deliver a letter. How about tag? I've always wanted to play that game. Let's play. You're it, Avin. Does Avin know how to play tag? Avin says he's not listening. Oh, is that him? Can't catch me! The Elder says, wow, Mile! Hey, Elder, we're playing tag. Come on, Elvin, you're it. Try harder. What the heck, says Avin. Sorry, Avin. He doesn't know how to play with someone his old age because... own age, because there aren't any in this village. Usually he's quiet, but it looks like he's very excited about you coming here. Really? Well, I'm done writing the letter. Avin received a letter to Sage. Go home safely. Give my best regards to Sir Lemuras. Letter entrusted by Elder Rowan, written as a reply to Lemuras. Wait, I totally forgot. We have an autumn festival in this village. It is to thank Nephthys, the Earth Spirit. If you'd like to, why don't you join us? Okay, that's why I talk to people again. This girl. Mile got away. He's a shy boy. I tried to put a ribbon on his fine blonde hair once, but his face turned red and he ran away. To this time. I thought we could go back behind the house. There's this guy here. This is anything new, right? Oh, what is it? I need to pick some vegetables to offer to Nephthys since the festival's coming soon. Besides, I have to send some to the capital, too. I'm gonna get busier and busier. Am I supposed to find him again? Maybe he ran off to the cottage to the north. But anyway, we have to deliver this letter. Maybe he'll be over there. Avin is still it, technically. Anyway, thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.